currently a documentary filmmaker. So I've been working on a documentary for like 2 years. So basically it's a documentary that I'm doing, investigative journalism documentary on Camry in Africa for Less. Basically I've wanted to just push on with my last documentary that I'd done, which was on Israel, so you can bring youth. I also film and edit events, so I've made that as part of my trade. I also work for Sky, Channel 4, ITV, all these big names, but I'd also tell you how I got there as well. I've directed an internal role for Channel 4 programme, so I was a freelance at Channel 4 where I had to cover a production assistant, where for a month I had to basically direct a 42-minute internal role, and it was really like, it was nerve-wracking. I just was thrown in the deep end, but that's what companies do to you. I worked as a PA shooting touring with me and Jamie Redknapp recently, so that was last year, February. That was really good. I'll tell you how I managed to get that, because that's not even part of my job and what I'd done at Sky anyway. I edited a social case study for Channel 4 Dramas, Channel 4 Drama Humans, and I filmed and edited internal for O2. I assisted on the shoot, filming a promo for TFI Friday for Channel 4. So yeah, as you can see, there's lots of things you can read for yourself. So in terms of filming, touring with me and Jamie Redknapp, I worked at Sky as a creative assistant, and I was very good with the Sky Sports team. I was wanting to kind of get to know people, network, and I had to basically speak to the creative director, who is quite a tough guy to come across and impress. So I had to speak to him and say, tell him about myself and tell him I really wanted to get onto shoots and just learn, and also just understand how exactly the shoot's done.
So what were you doing when that came about?
I was getting to know a lot of people at Sky, so I was just networking.
So really, you put yourself forward for that?
I did, yeah. So that one, a lot of people asked me, how did I get that? And I said, part of my job at Sky wasn't part of being on shoots. It was all about being in front of the computer, basically editing stuff.
Right.
So doing that job there, I'm quite thankful for it. But at the same time, I had to put myself out there. I had to kind of go and tell people who I am and also tell them exactly what I can do. So as well as going and saying, I want to get onto shoots, how is it going to benefit them that you're on the shoot? What do you want to learn? And how you want to shadow people and what else?
So you had to justify your involvement in the shoot.
Exactly.
And what arguments did you use?
I said to him, I sold myself to him. I kind of said to him, look, I'm doing a documentary. So I love film, I love being hands-on. And I explained the documentary to him, and he said it's very interesting. And I also said to him, my aim is to become a director anyway. So I want to shadow a director on shoot and learn exactly how things are shot.
Right.
And learn exactly what gets put into actually film. Because when you see all these nice things on TV, you know, all these promos, there's a lot that gets put into it. So when you're actually on there on the shoot, you're actually quite thankful to see how things are actually done. So it's quite amazing when you see that stuff.
So he said, okay, you can come along as production assistant.
Yeah.
And they were paying you to do that.
Yeah.
So you took yourself literally into the job. Okay.
Exactly. Humans, they had a lot of things going around on Twitter and Facebook, so I had to cut like a really short reel kind of explaining exactly how hyped up Humans has been with Twitter across it, Facebook, Snapchat, so I had to put it all together.
So really actually advertising what the programme was about.
Exactly.
And you had to encapsulate it in what, 30 seconds?
Yeah, and the thing is I had to use After Effects, and I know a lot of you guys probably in here like After Effects and you want to touch. I didn't even like that programme. Hate that program, but now I love it. Now I love it with a passion. I can use it. I can do what I can do on it, and I'm still learning new things with it. So that was being thrown in the deep end, because I said to them, I'll use After Effects, but really truly, I didn't know how to use After Effects. Kind of like blagged it, but I went on, looked online for tutorials. There was also someone there that worked in that same position, so I actually used a bit of his help as well. So
can you see how you have to be resourceful and think on your feet?
Yeah. You're gonna get thrown into the deep end in lots of jobs.
Absolutely.
So, like, they might say, "Oh, you gotta use Photoshop." You've put down your CV, you can Photoshop, and then you get a job that says, "Oh, you know, you wanna use Photoshop." You gotta just learn it. I had to learn how to use this camera in a day to basically do this O2 internal reel. I done a documentary on Is Fast Food Killing British Youth, and I just didn't want to see it as a dissertation. Whenever I do things, I just want to see it as what I'm doing it as. Just that I want to kind of push it and make it bigger and push it out there, and that's the mentality to have. So I said to myself, I've done a good documentary, and an external examiner singled it out. Kate really liked it, and from there, just pushed it to get a press release, and that's something that no one can take away from me, but it's an achievement, but as well as I put my all in it, and also I was very passionate about it, that's why it's gone to that stage.
So just be clear about this, people. When we say that your final year's portfolio could be a launch pad for your career, it's done it. Okay, depends what you're doing. Could be starting a magazine, making a documentary, producing a portfolio of work that ends up getting published, but you can use it as a launch pad. Daniel can do it, you can.
Yeah, I'm just, guys, like, of course, I've got a lot of experience here. You see achievements, like, wow, like, he's done so much, that's crazy. But I'm just the same, just like you. You know, like, we're all the same. Literally, all it is just switching on and just basically going out there, meeting people, going to events. Obviously, I'm going to show you places to look in a minute, but, like, just going out there, meeting people, becoming confident, like, and just actually wanting to actually get to the next stage. So I'm going to look at Paul for this because I find this so hilarious because when Paul used to say, get a contacts book, I used to look at Paul and I say, why the hell am I going to get a contacts book? I don't need a contacts book, I've got my phone. Why do I need a contacts book? It doesn't make sense. It never made sense to me at first, but then I've actually got my contacts book here today. I've actually got it. I've got it with me today. I'm actually gonna get it. Because basically, alright, basically, all my contacts are on here, but I'm transferring it into here. So this is not a special kind of book. It's just basically going Poundland or finding a scrappy notebook. Yeah, my phone. I could drop it in water. I could break it. Lost all your contacts. Here, you ain't really gonna lose this.
You can cross-reference? Do you sort of say, you know, spoke to Tom, therefore I know Harry?
Exactly. Put down the day you met them. Put down who they work for, their contact.
Maybe write down where you met them.
Where you met them, exactly.
Oh, you were at the O2 on Wednesday. Oh yeah, I remember now.
Exactly.
Put a reference, yeah.
I'm gonna tell you guys again, yeah? This is important, just get a contact book. Just pause a contact. You see where I'm coming from? Kate's a contact. You see where I'm coming from? All my lecturers are contacts. I graduated in 2014. I'm not just gonna head off from uni and be like, oh, you know what, I'm done now from uni. I've got contacts. I've got school teachers that are still contacts. Because you never know when you're gonna have to utilize them or just ask them something, do you know what I mean? Stay in contact with the lecturers, trust me, because it will really help. You think what I'm saying now is like, oh, yeah, whatever, but trust me. Just put them down as a contact because they'll really help, literally. Make sure you have a LinkedIn account, that's really important.
Who hasn't got a LinkedIn account?
If you haven't, you need to get one.
Who had? Come on.
Just walk out of this class, you haven't got one.
One. You're being honest. The others pretending that hasn't.
You hasn't got one? You haven't got one?
Why LinkedIn, Daniel? Why LinkedIn as opposed to Facebook? Why LinkedIn? Facebook would do, won't it?
Facebook would do, but LinkedIn. Facebook would do. Well, I'm actually lying. LinkedIn's really good because look, you get so many professionals on there, yeah, that will look at your account, like, and they're actually looking at your account, like, and if your account is not up to scratch, they're just gonna look at the next account until they find someone they want. I was this close to getting a job on LinkedIn, just through LinkedIn, because my account was up to scratch. The guy messaged me and said, okay, let's cut to the chase, Daniel. Your LinkedIn's really good. You 3-4 called me, put me in for an interview. Did I have to fill an application form? No. Why? Because my LinkedIn is up to scratch.
So in a way you're saying LinkedIn is almost an application form, a permanent application form.
Yeah,
it's
basically skipping the application. Application form, because no one likes application forms. Everyone here don't like, I don't like application forms. No one likes it. It's long. Like you got to fill in about 5 questions. Oh, why do you think you're great for this job? And of course we got to all start somewhere. But if you want to try, you know, get to a point where you want to skip these application forms.
So what have you got up there? You've got obviously a breakdown of what you've done.
Breakdown of what I've done.
Anything else up there?
My experience, right. Even links to things that you've done, showreels,
right.
Just certain things.
You put it all up there.
Blogs, if you want. You know, you can upload anything to LinkedIn anyway these days. You know, just certain things you're doing. Like, if you think something's not work experience, still put it down. It is work experience. Like, even if, you know, like, stuff that you've done, people like when you're honest, like, stuff you've done in uni. So if the first thing, you have to understand, everything I've got there on my CV, it wasn't like that when I first started.
Yeah.
The CV was, put it like this, like, I was gonna actually hold up this tissue. CV was like this, there was nothing on that CV, it was a blank piece of paper, do you know what I'm saying? So I started off, just like how everyone has started off, blank piece of paper. And the way I've got to fill that in, is going out there and look for opportunities. You can't wait for something to come to you, do you see where I'm coming from? Because if you're gonna end up doing that, you're not gonna move anywhere, do you know what I mean? So you've got to really like make these little changes. If you
have lots of media networking groups on LinkedIn as well that you can join.
And don't be scared to like you know, you might see someone that's like has relevant experience to you, like, oh, he works in journalism or radio. Don't be scared to message them. Oh, hi, you know, just a simple message. Conform as an email and just say this, oh, you know, it'll be great to come and shadow you or just come in and shoot a person that's a videographer or graphic designer or whatever you're interested in. That's an opportunity. You're creating your own opportunities. Don't be scared to message these people. They're just human beings just like us. So I've done it before. I was able to meet a person from LinkedIn and actually get on the shoot. They're always going to ask, okay, oh, what have you done? What's your experience? Be honest. I've done much, but I want to learn. Where's your work experience? So go think big is really good. A lot of these places I'm going to show you now of work experience, I never knew any of them. Like, and the way I've got to know more about it is about being more clued up on the industry, going to events, hearing out for things. So if you listen to radio, that's how you can hear about things. Like, radio actually taught me about Go Think Big. I heard about Go Think Big through radio. So listen to things, look out for things, have a good eye. Like, you know, when you're walking around, just think about what's around you. I look around, when I'm walking around, like, if there's a poster, last time I was in uni, I saw a poster and it said, you know, production crew wanted, you know, just anything that you see, just always look around and see what's going on around you, because that's how you actually get the opportunity. So I'm coming from. So Go Think Big is really good. Like, they have lots of good work experience stuff. They have jobs as well. Channel 4 work experience is happening very soon. I think it's in a couple months' time, I think, but it's good to just check the website. I've worked at Channel 4, so work experience is really good. ITV Insight program, that just ended, I think. Their program just ended, yeah. So, but it's really, I'm part of that program. Basically, what they do, it's basically like a LinkedIn group. It's a group basically that they put in all opportunities and people just apply, send an email to X and Y and just say, you know, I want to apply for this role, and then see whether you get the reply back or not. Sky work experience is good. There's lots going on right now. Just see what work experience is good for your field. So if it's journalism, if it's film, production, TV, whatever it may be. Other places to look is here. This place is really good. I can't pronounce it. If someone can pronounce it, you can pronounce it for me. This place is really good, like, for jobs.
Yeah.
It's really good for jobs. Like, and I only recently found out about that, probably maybe early last year, mid last year. But yeah, it's really good. Creative Access, I should have put something with that. Basically, Creative Access is only open to people like Black, Asians, like people from a disadvantaged background, basically. It's kind of building and allow more people to get into industry. Mental Media is good. Tiger Aspect's good, or to BBC. Give a Grad a Go is good. So when you guys like graduate, that place is really good. They have lots of opportunities on there. MTV, Mega TV, Line Pictures. Lots of these places, some might look scary to you. You know, BBC and MTV and Channel 4 and Sky, they're just companies, guys. Guys, I'm telling you, you'll be so surprised when you pass the application stage and you get into the company, how relaxed everyone is. Everyone's cool, everyone's nice. People are creative, some people are just wacky, you know, like, trust me, it's not a place where, you know, all you gotta do is become confident. And obviously confidence comes within time, it's not coming from. So don't be scared to go apply, to go to one, look at these places. When I wake up, yeah,
listen.
Every day when I wake up, yeah, and this might sound weird, now I'm going to tell you my little routine. I look myself in the mirror and say, what am I doing to get closer to my dream? Guys, just do that. What are you doing to get closer to your dream? Your dream may be, I want to become a production manager, I want to become a director, I want to become a graphic designer, or... Okay, if you want to become a graphic designer, what are you doing? Do you know After Effects? Do you know all these programs? Are you actually studying these programs? Are you becoming the best at what you do in your job? Guys, like, there's not more I can say, literally. If you want to start something, you got to start it. Like, push yourselves and actually go out there. Don't be afraid to make your own opportunities. So guys, obviously, you know, you can apply for work experience, you might not get it. Apply again, you might not get it. Apply again, you might not get it. Apply again, you might not get it in your life. God, why am I not getting no opportunities? Why are they not actually accepting me?
Well, just quickly, one of the things that you have to understand, and I think Daniel already understands it, is failure and setbacks are an integral part of the process. That's not a problem at all.
Mm.
Actually, it's how you respond to it. Yeah? And that is a lifelong process. You can have all manner of little setbacks, but if you're not experienced in something, you'll get that setback. I still get that now. But you then learn from it, and then you move on to the next stage. So as much as anything else, it's a case of how you respond to the setbacks. Don't let them destroy your confidence. Understand that you're on the path to succeeding. There is no other way. Yeah.
It's true. Like, you know, you see all this work experience I've got and jobs I've been at. Listen, I've been rejected so many times, like, to a point where it's ruined me. It's like, you feel like crap. For like, hell, I've been rejected from BBC. I've applied 3 times. Not after the third time, I was like, oh, you know what? I'm not gonna apply again. There was just a lot of opportunities that I felt that, you know, matched my skills, I didn't apply. But I kept applying, I kept going. You know, nothing's gonna stop me to a point where it's like, just cause I failed, I'm gonna stop applying. Don't feel that, okay, you're gonna go apply for a role, say on BBC or something, you don't get it. Doesn't mean you shouldn't apply again for a role BBC in the next 6 months or 4 months, do you know what I mean? Keep going, have that push, like, keep pushing yourself. You know what I mean? When I say don't be afraid to make opportunities, I mean, if you can't get work experience, because some people can't, you know, like, it's just not happening for you, then do something. Do you know what I mean? Like, create your own opportunity. You know, like, if you grab a camera and you learn to use that camera there, and you say, oh, you know what, actually, I want to start filming a little magazine show, a little web series, like a little funny thing, like, with my friends. That's you doing your own work experience. You've created your own work experience. Simple. You can put it on your CV. What's stopping you from not putting it on your CV? Obviously, depending on what obviously it is, but just be willing to do these things to make these opportunities, like grab a camera, or if it's, you know, just script writing, or if with journalism, just news writing, write about something. You know what I mean? Simple.
What do you mean by the next one? I think I know what you mean, but I want to hear you from you first.
Yeah.
Do one thing every day that scares you.
I don't go rob a bank. But what I'm trying to say there is basically, with that one, there's some things people don't want to do. Some things that people just don't want to actually... So I'm talking about, there's some things, when I first went into the industry, I didn't want to apply for certain things because I thought, you know what, I'm too scared for the setback, it's just going to be too much. So I'll talk about applying for the biggest companies, or, you know, like, for example, like Daily Mail, you know, that if there was like a role right now, some people feel like, oh, you know what, I'm not experienced enough for that, or it's quite scary to apply for that, I'm not too sure. So that's what I'm trying to say, do one thing every day that scares you. If that scares you, go for it and do it. You'll be surprised with the outcome.
Yeah, don't, precisely.
Simple.
The thing to do is, this is a lesson in life anyway. Confront your fears and make yourself do the thing that's scaring you, and you'll find that the fear of it slowly reduces. And on that one, a graduate from last year is working on Daily Mail Online, not in full employment, he's freelancing, so he must have had the courage to just say, I'll try. You can easily talk yourself out of it. Confront your fears and make yourself do the very thing that you're scared of doing. As Daniel says, it may not come off straight away. But if it doesn't, I bet you learn more about the industry as to why it didn't, and the next one will. Yeah?
So, some people want sleep more than they want success. That's something I will say to people. So, you know, just for example, A's up at 9 a.m., B's up at midday, C's up at 1 p.m. Well, what do you think is going to happen with B and C? Obviously, they've missed opportunity. It's that simple. A's getting opportunity because A's up at 9 a.m. looking for jobs, going out there, grinding, simple. So, you know, obviously, we all love sleep. I mean, I love sleep. I could sleep now, but come on, like, if you really want your opportunities, you really want to get out there, just push yourself and just actually just make the opportunity. Like, I'll give an example. So, we'll talk to Dan. I remember there was a day I committed myself just to call up universities and call up colleges, because basically I'm doing these talks at different unis. So call up universities and call up colleges, explain to them what I want to do to come in to inspire young students just like yourself, and done that for a whole day. I haven't eaten since morning. I'm not trying to say I'm starving myself. What I'm trying to say is that I'm that passionate about this that I want to just push it, and I want it to come successful. So I'm not gonna sleep. I'm just gonna actually cut back on some things and be like, you know what, let's push it. You know what I mean? That's the kind of mentality you've got. You've got to change your mentality, and then things will start coming for you. If you just change the way you think, change the way you sleep, change the way you just do things, things will start coming for you, I'm telling you. Obviously, a visual reaction is just a dream. So obviously a lot of people have visualized a lot of things. For example, you know, you can say, oh yeah, I'm gonna drive the biggest car, and just for example, I'm gonna drive the biggest car and whatever. We haven't even got a license yet. Do you know what I mean? No worries. You can say, oh, you know, like, I'm gonna be the next biggest director. You haven't even learned how to create a treatment, or just even, you haven't even used a camera before, you haven't even done editing before, you haven't done nothing. So if you have a vision, start putting action to it and just actually push with it as well. Obviously, being lazy is guaranteed to win every chance of success you get. Everyone's got their different traits, no one's perfect, you know, but just don't be lazy. Go out there, go push for it, go get it, because, you know, no one likes someone that's lazy. Basically, a lot of people in this industry, they want someone that's actually going to be on the ball, hands-on, and just does the work. Next one's really important. Do it now, sometimes later becomes never. So, for example, like I was saying, get the contacts book. Do it now. Oh yeah, I'm going to be done in 3 months' time. All you got to do is just get a book, write it on contacts, simple. Do it now. I'm going to apply for this role, like, yeah. Oh yeah, it expires anyway, end of the month. Yeah, I'll just do it, like, next week. Oh, stop procrastinating. Do it now. Just do it. Because if you keep saying that, you're going to miss opportunities. You're going to just miss what's going on. And then you're stuck in just in the same place you were, like, in the last couple of months, you're still in the same place. And this is really important to me, so there's no reason to have a plan B because it distracts your plan A. So obviously of course everyone has a plan B, but your plan A should really obviously be your aim. Yeah? And put all your effort in that so that you can obviously push it to become what you want it to become. Because in the end, you know, no one really wants to go for their plan B. Everyone wants their plan A is like, okay, I want to actually get onto talk shows, whatever it is. And then your plan B is like, really true, you'll just work in a normal place where you don't even like it. Do you know what I mean? So if it's important to you, you'll find a way. If it's not, you'll find an excuse. And that basically means, you know, if you really want it, you'll find a way to do it. If you don't, you'll find an excuse. Oh, you know, I didn't apply for that because, I just tired. I was like, well, there you go. Obviously, it's not important to you, so it's just that simple. That's all my contacts, anyway. That's my Instagram. That's my email. If you want to guys write that down, and if you have any questions for me, you can ask. Well, thank you for listening, anyway.
I'm from Devon, and obviously all these big companies are all based in London. I do like independent films down there, working as like behind the scenes photographer. But would that count as enough experience to then go and get a job in one of these big companies? because I feel like I've applied for stuff before and they've said that I haven't had enough experience. But I don't know if it's because they're looking for the big names or...
Well, it is. Sometimes some places, they're a bit like, oh, you need this certain amount of experience to get the actual role. And they're like, you know, you need 3 years this, 4 years that, 2 years this. I don't know how long obviously you've been working there for, but it's not even to do with whether you're working the name of it and they're like, okay, we can't take you because it's not as big as this place, whatever it is. It's just about, yeah, they want you to have just a bit more experience on your hands. So just dip and dab into different things, whatever you're doing, if it's cinematography or if it's a lot of running or something like that, just do a lot more running jobs, and they probably want to see you at different companies, not just that, just one certain company. So you can always just look into different indie companies, and even those places I gave you, there's lots of running places, running jobs as well.
Cool.
What was Thierry Henry like?
Thierry Henry was...
How did you like, if you don't mind me asking that, what steps did you take to get to that type of people, like,
yeah.
What did they look for?
For Sky. Be yourself. Like, don't. I think what people get wrong is that they go into these companies and they thought they've got to conform and stuff. I'm still myself. I'll still speak the same way I speak, dress the same way I dress. I'll come into work in a tracksuit. That's just how. That's who I am. So just be yourself. And you know, I think one thing they look for is actually, you have to be consistent. Like, consistency is really key when it comes to media. Like, you know, someone could ask you, what's the last thing you worked on? You know, like, someone at Sky could ask, what's the last thing you worked on? I'd be like, I worked on this thing, but, and they'll be like, oh, what was that? 2 years ago, and be like, oh, okay, well, that's not even relevant. It's 2 years ago. So consistency and your mentality and also motivation and also just determination, you know, like, have that positive mindset about you. And always, one thing that always they love is, like, if you are really wanting to get to know people, you know, just networking is key. Networking, as soon as you network and you get to know people, it's one of the things they really like. But Thierry Henry was a funny guy. Like, he was great working with him. And it's a blessing, of course, but, when you work with these people, you start to actually understand a lot of things on media, how things are actually done in media. If it's on shoot, if it's on location, whatever it is.
What I picked up on from that lesson was, if you're doing one job, there's no harm in actually talking to somebody else. So, I don't know, if you're Daily Telegraph news desk, and you actually think you've got a really good foreign affairs feature, go over to the foreign desk. You know, you that's what you have to do. Essentially, it's the same principle that you convey. You may be working in one department, but you put yourself in front of another department as well and say, I'd like to try and do this.
That's literally what,
if you're not physically there, you're not going to be in a position to do it. So when you're actually in the building, take full opportunity of other things that you could possibly create for yourself.
Yeah, so if you've got a job at Sky, for example, and you know, because I was in Sky Creative. So Sky Creative is a big department. You've got sports, you've got entertainment. Got work and marketing as well, that stuff. So, you know, if you're in a department, just don't think, yeah, I'm in my department, just do my job. Go talk to other people. So I spoke to graphic designers, I spoke to just creatives, directors. I love speaking to people, that's what it is. So if you're not that kind of person, it's gonna be very hard for you to kind of move around and experience a lot of things with media. If you're one that can actually go talk to people and push yourself and actually get to know actually exactly how it's done, because I can get a promo, but I want to know exactly how that was done, and I managed to actually see how it was done when I was at the shoot. So and obviously, you know, some people, you know, they have to build up the confidence and stuff. I understand that. I think with the way they're building up the confidence, if you're not that confident to go speak to people, just start off first by, you know, having a thing where you speak to, you kind of like mingle with the right people, and you're able to just also go to events. Events is really good. Like, there's like stuff like, they might be like, oh, you know, we're doing a few drinks at this place, go to those things, because you'll start to mingle with a lot of people and it starts to become normal to you, so you can actually just speak to anybody.